Today's video is sponsored by Surfshark VPN. Alright, so in this video, I'm going to show you how to own a lot of Bugattis. Sounds nice, right? Alright, so in today's video, I'm going to show you how to realistically integrate 3D cars into your scene. So here's what we've done. I had Enzoe recording with the Panasonic S1H, so we capture high detail ProRes footage to capture all the details so it's easier for tracking, and he is walking backwards while I'm doing my talk, and we just act like there are going to be a bunch of cars. And then we also need a 360 image of location, because this is the most important thing for cars. Cars are highly reflective, so they often look very fake when you're trying to achieve them in 3D. One of the biggest problems is because you don't see the realistic reflections from the environment captured on your car, or the lighting is off. So we are going to capture a 360 image using the Insta360 ONE X2. This captures a 360 image at multiple exposures through the app. I can control that. So I take a bunch of photos, underexposed, mid-exposed, normal exposed, higher exposed, overexposed, then import it in Photoshop, merge them together as an HDR image, which if I export it translates into an HDRI, which is an HDR environment. I think, but it's I, and environment is with E, so I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. So I went to Spain recently, and I was already following a series here in Belgium on Netflix. Unfortunately, when I arrived in Spain, I couldn't follow that series anymore because it wasn't available on Netflix Spain. So luckily, I had Surfshark VPN that allowed me to log in from another location in the world, which was, in this case, Belgium. Once I did that and logged back in Netflix, I was able to continue and watch my series relaxed. So that's one of the biggest reasons why you would want a VPN, and also for the security of everything that you do online. Third-party trackers can't follow anymore what you're doing online. They also have a no-log policy, so everything you do isn't logged anywhere and is completely in your control. You can check out more with the link in the description, and if you use my coupon code INYAS, which you see right now on screen, or if you would scan in the QR code, then you will be able to buy a 24 months plan with 3 months for free and an 83% discount, which is insane. And if that isn't good enough, you also get a 30 days money back guarantee. Check it out, link is in the description. Let's get back with the video. Anyway, you have an HDRI, you can now import that in your 3D software, so we're going to use that later. So I'm going to import my footage in Adobe After Effects, and then I'm going to use the mask tool to mask myself out roughly. So the reason why I did that is so now we can apply the 3D camera tracker to our footage, and it won't look at those pixels, so it won't be misinformed with a moving object that is supposed to be static. So then we're going to apply the 3D camera tracker and also enable advanced analysis. This is going to leave us with a 3D camera track of our footage. Then I'm going over to a place which I will consider the center point of my scene, and I'm going to set ground and origin point here in After Effects. Then I'm going to create a bunch of solids all over my location, just so I kind of get a grasp of the size of the location. And then I'm going over to File, Export, and export this for Maxon Cinema 4D. And then I'm going to import this in Cinema 4D, and I'm going to search online for a Bugatti 3D model. I found this 3D model right here, and I imported that in Cinema. Apart from that, I did some small tweaks to this model because I thought it wasn't high detail enough, but I could have spent a lot more time to creating an even higher quality model. So it also kind of matters how you have modeled the entire car. If it's high detail, high poly, it's often going to look a lot more realistic than a low poly car that you're probably downloading for a game, let's say. So make sure that you are working with a high quality product, and if not so, you might need to tweak it in 3D here and there. By the way, if you're really interested in learning more regarding VFX, we're actually going to be launching our Epic VFX Academy once again. And I know you've all been waiting for this, but it's finally here. This October, we're going to open the doors to a handful of students to join the Epic VFX Academy. Here you will learn Epic VFX from A to Z, After Effects, Cinema 4D type of stuff. And you're going to join a Discord group server with all of the students. And you can also discuss problems and share your work for feedback. We will also organize weekly Zoom calls where my team and I will be supporting you, answering questions or giving feedback on your work to finally reach that next level. If this sounds something for you, definitely check out the link in the description below, sign up for the waitlist before it's too late, and you'll hear from us. All right, let's get back to the video. Then I also textured this completely using Redshift. And here is the cool part. You can either texture this completely on your own using a bunch of techniques, or you can use Grayscale Gorillas Hub and just use their material library to texture your car. And actually they have so many materials that I didn't have to touch anything or have some small tweaks here and there. So I searched their car paint materials, I searched their chrome, their metals and their rubbers, the black plastics, all this kind of stuff that you would see in a car, glass, tinted glass, emission, red emission, white emission for the lights in the front, and then just start texturing your entire car. Then I'm going to create a dome light and import my HDRI here into my scene. After texturing one Bugatti, you can start copying it over the entire location, and it's really as easy as that, and just changing out the materials, making different looks. One important thing here that I've done is open up a bunch of Bugattis that are street photographed just to get an idea of how they look in real life. Anyway, I used the Redshift render engine here to render out my cars, and I thought they gave me a really nice and realistic results. I also added a big plane that is going to be my ground, and added a Redshift object tag and create a matte object and cast shadows. This is going to be our shadow catcher, so it allows all the shadows to be caught but not show anything on the surface. Another really important thing is that I'm going to project my original video onto this plane, but you're not going to see this because of this matte that we just created, but we need to apply it anyway because it's still going to be caught up and the information of the reflections. So what I want to do is create a new material and add a camera mapping node. Here I'm going to import my video, make sure to go over to animation and detect all the frames, and then apply this into the diffuse color of your material. Then apply this material to your ground plane, and you will see that your video is now projected completely towards the camera. Also make sure to drag in your camera though in the camera mapping as the camera, otherwise it's not going to work. By the way, we quickly want to thank Corsair. They did not sponsor this video, but from time to time, we receive products to support our work.
Let me tell you, we need some serious power to create visual effects for you guys. So luckily, Corsair sent over their RM750X 80 Plus Gold Modular Power Supply. This power supply is just what you expect from Corsair. Very nice build quality, reliable, and looks pretty. Check out more with the link in the description below, and let's continue with the video.
You can even cast reflections onto your ground again if you want to, but for this type of shot it wasn't really necessary because it was an overcast day and we didn't see any reflections for any car on the spot. But let's say you would have a wet floor, it's possible. Alright, so I'm going to export this to After Effects and do some final tweaking. Very important is usually it exports a very crisp image of a car or a 3D render of a car, and it's usually too sharp. So I'm going to add in a fast box blur here, also add in some grain, some distortions, things like that, and match the colors of your shot. So look around at the highest highlight of your shot, and then look at the highest highlight on your cars and try to match those. Then look at the shadows in your shot, and then look at the shadows of your cars. And in the info tab, just try to match those numbers. After that, you're left with a realistic car render, and you look like you own a bunch of Bugattis. That brings us to this final result. Enjoy. Everyone always asks, what color is your Bugatti? Well, you tell me. Asks, what color is your Bugatti? Well, you tell me. All right. Alright, so that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell to stay notified when I upload new videos. Apart from that, I'm going to leave you with another video of mine right here so you can continue your VFX journey, and I'll see you in the next one. Until then, create epic videos.